Hi everybody, today we are here with Professor Virtanen to talk about biodiversity crisis and values. Professor Virtanen, how values are connected to biodiversity?
Thanks. So discussions on biodiversity and biodiversity loss involve different values and they are far from being universals. By values, we mean preferences, considerations and standards of something that is important. Things that are worth aiming at, are beneficial and should produce a desirable end. Values influence behavior, people's beliefs and aims set by individuals and collectives. At higher political levels, values guide decision making as well as one's own choices about everyday life, such as habits of consumption. Biodiversity can have a multiple and interlinked values, and values can be changeable as well as conflicting. Values may also be contextual, so they are contextual dependent.
Very good. So we see the importance of values, but what are the biodiversity values?
Okay, so firstly, I would like to say that it's important to highlight that values, the importance given to certain issues, cannot be separated from one's ideas of what exists, ontology, so to say, and what are the grounds for knowledge, so epistemology. And in fact, there are many different ways to classify biodiversity values, and traditionally they have been divided into intrinsic and instrumental values. But there are also relational, ecological, economic, social and cultural values, such as aesthetic values, among others. And we can really identify interlinkages between them, and they are not always so easy to put to the different boxes of intrinsic and instrumental values.
I understand. And can you give some example of these values that you mentioned?
Right, so let's start with the relational value that I mentioned. It's very difficult to put it into these two traditional boxes. I have carried out research with Amazonian indigenous societies whose teachings from an earlier age emphasize that the environment and humans are interdependent. The aim is to form reciprocal relations with the environment rather than control and exploit it. Relational values of biodiversity point to the relations that different species and beings have, and that they are really regarded mutually beneficial. Trees, other plants, animals, rivers or mountains can be seen as a part of human life and treated in kin terms, as a part of family. In this way of thinking, in this relational way of thinking, harming nature can be regarded even as a crime against humanity on the account of the interconnections between humans and other than humans, or more than human beings, if you want to use that term. Intrinsic value really means that something should be protected for its own sake. And in this notion, the diversity of life or specific species, such as animals and plants, are seen as having a value in their own right or rights as humans do. For instance, the creation of strict protected areas draws from this value, and then humans can be seen as the main cause of environmental degradation. Furthermore, in Western discussions of biodiversity, if we take an example of instrumental value, this is actually quite often present in discussions. Then biodiversity is regarded as good for something else, as a means to achieve certain ends. Biodiversity can be regarded as crucial in serving diverse human interests, such as providing a range of materials and sources, subsistence, medicines, and oxygen that sustain life. It also provides resilience to climate change. So this is very typical instrumental value. These are instrumental values that we see in biodiversity. We can also identify economic value of biodiversity, which is linked to valuing certain natural resources for creating, for instance, commercially marketable products for markets or that can be exchanged. For some people, biodiversity can be useful only in terms of possible resource extraction, for example. Then there are ecological values, which are strongly present in the discussions about the future of the ecosystems of the planet. Diverse connected existences, big and small, from microbes to humans. And protection of larger ecological systems with specific connectors or just single keystone species often convey ecological values. Then I would like to mention social and cultural values of biodiversity. They refer to relationships that have been created with certain species, landscapes and ecosystems, which can be important in monetary terms or non-monetary terms. For instance, reindeer herding for the Sami people is at the same time cultural and economic and social and aesthetic. A little bit more on cultural and social values, I would like to mention that this can be important for individuals or for collectives. And there are also spiritual values that biodiversity may embed. And these can be recognized historically in arts, in language, and in diverse ritual uses that, for instance, certain species and animals have. So then there are specific cultural values, and we can also define them as spiritual values. They can be very vital for humans' well-being and health. And so then lastly, the aesthetic values of biodiversity, they refer to the experiences of something as beautiful, or experience of beauty and pleasure. Certain species, populations and places may affect humans at sensory level and give, for example, emotions of connectedness or recreation. For instance, certain sounds of animals or waves or just silence or the sounds of trees as we have here in this park, smells, tastes and touch, they can be valued as meaningful, or they may be, as I said, give a certain feeling of pleasure. Aesthetic values may also guide biodiversity protection decisions when certain species are protected because they are thought on the basis of being beautiful or other aesthetic values that I just mentioned. Aesthetic values are also present in valuing certain landscapes. We can talk about biocultural landscapes or places that are important to establish, for instance, intergenerational connections. And studies have really shown that there are strong interlinkages between cultural and ecological values, between the vitality of culture, language diversity and biodiversity. Environmental degradation often increases cultural vulnerability because of loss of language and knowledge related to the environment.
Thank you very much, Professor Virtanen. So now, importantly, we mention all these values, but why is it important to understand the different values of biodiversity?
Well, for instance, the social and cultural values that I just mentioned, they are important to understand and map, identify, in order to guarantee the multi-linguistic and multicultural planet. And when carrying out sustainability education, it's really important to identify these diverse values that there exist in biodiversity discussions. They guide the design of different mechanisms. These mechanisms can be drawn from intrinsic values, cultural, ecological or other values. But a critical eye should be paid to those values and preferences which are counted. For instance, do the values of large-scale economic production count or the relational values of local peoples? And who defines what is beautiful or which species' survival is more important? Are biodiversity benefits considered in the long term or short term? All these issues are really important and really related to values. So mapping biodiversity values is crucial for understanding and guiding people's behavior, their plans for the future, their choices and their priorities. And many civil actors in one area may have different values. For instance, in the Arctic area, the forest owners, farmers and Arctic indigenous peoples may have really different values. And social and cultural values especially, they embed ontological and epistemological dimensions that are important to recognize. And it's really important also to note that we can educate people to value more biodiversity.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Professor Virtanen.
Thank you so much.